Many people ask me about medications and whether or not the medication that they've been taking has been the cause of their hair loss. I'm going to answer to that question today. The first and foremost question is, medications can cause hair loss. Whether or not they can cause hair loss? The answer is yes. People are asking about blood thinners, gout medications, chemotherapy, vitamins, birth control medication, and antidepressants, even some hair loss medications. Many of the medications have hair loss as one of the very remote side effects, and a lot of people are taking chronically a bunch of medications. So it's very easy to find hair loss in one of those medications and blame it for the hair loss that you have. However, you have to be checked with a hair specialist to see whether or not the hair loss is actually because of medications. And if it does have to do with medications, your medication could be adjusted. Don't stop your medication, especially if you're on a medication for long term. Check with your primary care physician or the physician that puts you on medication for any reason. At times they have to replace it with something else, or the medication may not be the cause of hair loss. So be very careful about it, and a hair loss consultation is definitely can answer many of those questions. One of the other more important question or more common question that the people are asking me is whether or not steroids can cause hair loss. Yes, steroids can cause hair loss. We have different types of steroids. There's some anti-inflammatory steroids like cortisone and similar medications. They can cause hair loss in long term. You have to look at the pros and cons if you have to take those medications. The other type of medications are anabolic steroids that people are using for bodybuilders. Many of them are having androgenetic effects, so they are acting like testosterone. They may even be from the family of testosterone. They may get converted to dehydrotestosterone, which is a big factor in hair loss. So if you're one of those and you start losing hair, you have to be careful. The other thing is, some people you are using steroids for replacement treatment. Some men who have never had hair loss at the age of 40, 50s, they start taking replacement anabolic steroids or with testosterone, and they see that they start losing hair. That is a catch-up hair loss. They haven't lost the hair, probably because the testosterone has never been at the normal level. Now that they're resuming the testosterone at the level that they should have been, now they're seeing the hair loss that they should have seen earlier. So if you have hair loss, steroids, testosterone, male hormones, definitely check with a physician. You may not even have to be stopping your medication. You may just take medication to reverse the effects of steroids or testosterone. Another common question is whether or not vitamins can help your hair to grow your hair better. The answer to this question is that most of the people in North America, at least, people who have normal diet without any major deficiency, they should not need vitamins to maintain their hair or to make their hair better. In fact, vitamin is not a hair loss medication. They are having vitamins for hair and nails in supply stores, in vitamin shops. They have zinc, they have biotin, they have all elements that we need for having a healthy hair. However, if you're having a normal and balanced diet, you don't need to take those medications. They're not necessarily helping your hair. Many of my patients are coming to me using these medications for years. We usually look at the normal diet, and if they have it pretty balanced, we ask them to stop it, and they are not seeing any hair loss by stopping the medications. I hope you all learned about medications and whether or not medication could cause hair loss. If you've been on medication, it could have been some relief to you, or you may want to get more consultation from your doctors about the medication that you're taking. If you like more of these question and answers, and if you want to follow us, don't forget to subscribe at the section below. And if you have any medical question, don't forget to ask them in the comment section. I will make sure that we get back to them and we respond to your questions as soon as we can. Also, like our videos, and we would like to see how your reactions are to our videos. That will promote us and encourage us to work and make more videos for you in the future. Thank you.